గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ నాన్న. జూమ్ క్లాస్ కండక్ట్ చేయని రీజన్ ఏంటంటే, జూమ్ క్లాస్ 40 మినిట్స్ లో మనకి లెస్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కవర్ అవుతున్నాయి. సో మోర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కవర్ చేయడం కోసం ఆబ్జెక్ట్ లో మోర్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ బిట్స్ ఉన్నాయి కాబట్టి డైరెక్ట్ గా యూట్యూబ్ ఛానల్ మీకు లింక్ పంపిస్తున్నాను. ఆ యూట్యూబ్ ఛానల్లో ఎవ్రీడే డిఫరెంట్ డిఫరెంట్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఉంటాయి. ఎక్స్టర్డే ఎక్సైడ్ 2లో 2-3 బిట్స్, 5 బిట్స్, 4-5 బిట్స్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ చేశారండి. నా స్టార్ట్ అగైన్ ఫ్రమ్ ది ఎక్సైడ్ 2 ఆన్వర్స్, ఎందుకంటే కొంతమంది క్లారిటీ లేదన్నారు, వాయిస్ క్లారిటీ లేదన్నారు, వీడియో క్లారిటీ లేదన్నారు, బికాస్ ఆఫ్ క్లైమేట్ వల్ల. క్లైమేట్ క్లౌడీగా ఉంది, మామూలుగా ఇదిగా ఉంది కాబట్టి మనకి సిగ్నల్ ఒకసారి అందచ్చు అందకపోవచ్చు. సో అది ప్రాబ్లం ఉంది కాబట్టి డైరెక్ట్గా నేను యూట్యూబ్ లింక్ పంపిస్తాను. సో ఫస్ట్ క్వశ్చన్, ఆర్త్ టర్మ్ ఇన్ ద ఎక్స్పాన్షన్ ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ 1/2x హోల్ పవర్ 20. ఆర్త్ టర్మ్ ఈజ్ ద మిడిల్ టర్మ్ ఇది ఆస్ గివెన్. Then find the r plus 3 term. We know that index n is even. Then middle term is tn by 2 plus 1. Middle term is tn by 2 plus 1. Suppose index n is r, then tn plus 1 by 2 comma tn plus 3 by 2 are two middle terms here. That concept we know very well. Now coming to the given problem. Power index is the 20. 20 is a even number. 20 is a even number. So tn by 2 plus 1 is the middle term. 20 index. 20 is even. So tr-th term is middle term. That is t20 by 2 plus 1. That is t10 plus 1 means t11. T11. So r equal to 11. They asked to find r plus 3 term. So tr plus 3. That is t11 plus 3. That is t14. Tr. You have to write 14 can be written as something plus 1. That is 13 plus 1. We know the formula tr plus 1. Tr plus 1 is ncr x power m minus r a power r formula have. So tr plus 1 substituting the formula. In place of n is 20. 20 is say 13. X square whole power. 20 minus 13 minus 1/2x whole power 13. That is a minus 4 odd number is minus. NCR is NCN minus R. NCR form NCN minus R. 20C 13 can be done. 20C. 20 minus 13 is 7. X power, X square whole power 7. That means X power 14 by 2 power 13 into X power 13. That is a minus 20C 7. X power 13 cancel, remain x by 2 power 13 is the answer. Copy that problem. Coming to next question. Small a is the quotient of the middle term in the expansion 1 plus x whole power 2n. Two expansions, binomial expansions are given, 1 plus x whole power 2n, one expansion. One more expansion, 1 plus x whole power 2n minus 1. Now, 2n minus 1 in the second expansion. In the first expansion, 2n is even. So, middle term is, 2n is, this is the even number. So, middle term we have, tn by 2 plus 1, that is 2n by 2 plus 1. Right, 2n, tn plus 1. So apply the formula tr plus 1, 2n cn x power n. So a is the quotient of middle term is given. Quotient of middle term. Right, 2n cn. Now in this case, 1 plus x whole power 2n minus 1. 2n minus 1 is the odd. This is the odd. So middle term we have two middle terms. Middle terms. We have tn plus 1 by 2 and tn plus 3 by 2. That is 2n minus 1 plus 1 by 2 comma t2n minus 1 plus 3 by 2. So that is a minus 1 plus 1 cancel tn comma tn plus 1. So tn here can write tn minus 1 plus 1. So that is 2n minus 1 c n minus 1 x power n minus 1. In this case, quotient is b. This is the b value. B equal to 2n minus 1, c n minus 1. Next, tn plus 1. Next term, tn plus 1. That is the 2n minus 1, c n, x power n. In this case, quotient is c. That is 2n minus 1, c n. They are asking to find the relation between the a, b, c. You have to find the relation between the a, b, c. Observe the b and c, it is in the form of ncr plus ncr minus 1. If you add the b plus c, that is 2n minus 1 c n minus 1 plus 2n minus 1 c n. This is in the form of ncr plus ncn minus, ncr minus 1. That formula is n plus 1 c r. R and r minus 1 consecutive, r is the bigger compared to r minus 1. Here n and n minus 1 consecutive, n is a bigger. So this value is n is a 2n minus 1, 2n minus 1 plus 1 cn. That is the 2n cn. This value is given a. Therefore a equal to b plus c is the relation. A equal to b plus c here. Copy the problem. Now coming to next question. The quotient of middle terms in the both expansions are equal is given. First expansion 1 plus alpha x whole power 4. Second expansion 1 minus alpha x whole power 6. So this is in the form of 1 plus x whole power n. Index 4 is even. So middle term is t4 by 2 plus 1. So that is t2 plus 1. The formula 4c2 alpha x whole square. So this is the 4c2 alpha square x square. In this case 6 is the even. So t6 by 2 plus 1. That is t3 plus 1. Substitute in the formula. We get 6c3 minus alpha x whole cube. Minus for odd number is minus. So in this case you have minus 6c3 alpha cube x cube. So middle terms of the quotients are equal. Quotient of middle term in 1 plus alpha x whole power 4 equal to quotient of middle term in 1 minus alpha x whole power 6 is given. So equate the both quotients. So in this case first left hand side quotient is 4c2 alpha square. Right side quotient you have minus 6c3 alpha cube. 4c2 means 4 into 3 by 2 into 1 alpha square equal to minus 6 into 5 into 4 by 3 into 2 into 1 alpha cube. So cancel it 2 to the 6 alpha square equal to minus 20 alpha cube. Then alpha equal to minus 6 by 20. That is the minus 6 by 20 means we get minus 3 by 10 is the answer. Copy it. Next concept. Find the numerically greatest term in the expansion 2a minus 3b whole power 19. We have the formula a plus b whole power n. N plus 1 into mod b by mod a plus mod b. Is not an integer. That means some integer plus fraction value. Then numerically the greatest term is tp plus 1. Suppose n plus 1 into mod b by mod a plus mod b value. If it is an integer, then tp comma tp plus 1 are the numerically greatest terms. Tp comma tp plus 1 are the numerically greatest terms. And compulsory mod b by a value should be less than 1 even. Mod b by value should be less than 1. Before applying the formula, you can apply the mod b by a value less than 1 or greater than 1. If it is less than 1 means, okay, no problem. If it is greater than 1 means, you can apply the formula n plus 1 into mod a by mod a plus mod b value. Same conditions it is applying. Now coming to the given 2a minus 3b whole power 19. So mod b by a means modulus of minus 3 by 2a. That value is minus 3 into 2 by 3 by 2 into 1 by 4. We get 4, we get that is greater than 1. So don't take this formula. You have to apply second one, you can apply n plus 1 into mod a by mod a plus mod b value. You have to apply the formula. So check the n plus 1 into mod a by in place of a 2a in place of b minus 3b have 2a plus modulus of minus 3b. Apply 19 plus 1 into modulus of 2 times of a is 1 by 4 by 2 times of 1 by 4 plus modulus of negative is positive 3 into 2 by 3. So there is a 20 into 1 by 2 by 1 by 2 plus 2, that is a 10 by 2 by 5, 4. So this is an integer. Now this is an integer you have. That is an integer. Then TP comma TP plus 1 are the numerically greater sums. TP comma TP plus 1 are the numerically greater sums. This is an integer P. Therefore TP comma TP plus 1 are numerically greatest terms. NGT means numerically greatest sum. T4, that is a T3 plus 1. That is NCR 19C3 2A whole power 19 minus 3 minus 3B whole power 3. So 19C3 we know that 9 minus 4 odd number is minus 19C3. 2 times of A means 1 by 4 whole power 19 minus 3 is 16. Minus 4 odd number is minus, minus are written outside. 3 times of B value is 2 by 3 whole cube. 3, 3 get cancelled. That is the minus 19C3. 1 by 2 whole power 16. 2 cube. So this value is minus 19C3. 2 cube by 2 power 16 means 1 by 2 power 13. Copy it. Next, TP plus 1 means T4 plus 1, T5 also you can find. Options is given, that option is given 19C3, 2 power 13 is given. 19C3 into 1 by 2 power 13. Sometimes they will give the TP plus 1 also they will give. That means T4 plus 1 will get. That means 19C5, 2A whole power 19 minus 5, minus 3B whole power 5 will give. 4, sorry. That is T4 plus 1. T4 plus 1 is 19C4, 2A whole power 19 minus 4, minus 3B whole power 4. 19C minus 4 or even number is plus 19C4, 2A means 2 into 1 by 4, that is 2, 1 by 2 whole power 15. 3B, 3 into 2 by 3, that is 2 power 4. That means 19C4, 1 by 2 power 11 also sometimes they will be the answer. But in our middle they given this one. This problem in 2018 they asked. Coming to next question. If the middle term in the expansion 1 plus x whole power 2n is given this value 1 into 3 into 5 into and so on 2n minus 1 by n factorial into k, then you have to find the value of k. Here you can observe this is that 2n is even. Index 2n is even. So middle term is tn by 2 plus 1. That is tn plus 1. The tn plus 1 value is 2n cn x power n. But this is given. This term that is 1 into 3 into 5 and so on, 2n minus 1 by k by n factor. But 2n cn value is, 2n cn value is how? 1 into 3 into 5 and so on, 2n minus 1 by n factor into 2 power n. This is the IPE point of view I explained. That value you should remember, 2n cn value is 1 into 3 into 5 into n so on, 2n minus 1 by n factor into 2 power n. So left hand side 2n cn, you can apply 1 into 3 into 5 into n so on, 2n minus 1 by n factor into 2 power n. Extra I have x power n. This is given 1 into 3 into 5 and so on, 2n minus 1 by n factor into k. These two get cancelled. K value is 2 power n into x power n, that is 2x whole power n is the answer. Copy. Coming to next question, the quotient of 1 plus x whole power 40. By above problem, 1 plus x whole power 2n, middle term, have 1 into 3 into 5 into n so on, 2n minus 1 by n factor into 2 power n into x power n you have. So same, in place of 2n you have 40. In place of 2n you have 40, that means n equal to 20. N equal to have 20. So middle term is, one into three into five and so on, two times of 20 minus one by n factor means 20 factor into 2 power 20 into x power 20. That is a 1 into 3 into 5 and so on, 2 times of 20 means 40. 40 minus 20 is, 40 minus 1 is 39. By 20 factor into 2 power 20 into x power 20. Coming to the problem, they are asking the quotient of middle term. So quotient of middle term, term equal to 1 into 3 into 5 and so on, 39 by 20 factor into 2 power 20 is the answer. Copy the problem. Coming to next question, this is also 2018. They ask in the 2018, sum of the infinite terms alternately have plus minus here. Alternately have plus minus. Observe, this is the denominator multiple of 4. So multiple of 4 means x by q value is 1 by 4. X by q value is 1 by 4. One more thing you have, this can be written as 1 by 4 into 1, 1 by 1 into 1 by 4. Minus 5 by 4 into 1, 4 into 2. 2 factor into 1 by 4 whole square. Plus 5 into 7 by 3 factor into 1 by 4 whole cube. Check it is in the standard form or not. What is the standard form you have? 1 minus x whole power minus p by q. What is the form you have? 1 minus, sorry, alternately plus minus means between plus you have. So 1 minus p into x by q plus p into p plus q by 2 factor into x by q whole scale. This is the form I have. But here x by 2 factor before minus sign is there. So minus common. That becomes a 1 by 1 into 1 by 4. Plus becomes a minus. 5 by 2 factor into 1 by 4 whole scale. Plus becomes a minus. 5 into 7 by 3 factor into 1 by 4 whole cube. Plus and so on. Directly you have right. I will explain direct method. Not necessary to do everything. You can see x by q value obviously 1 by 4. But every series by 1 is a power 1, power 2 factor is a product of 2 terms whole square. 2 factor product of 1 term whole square you have. That means need one more term. 7 minus 5 is 2. 5 minus how much is a 2? That is 5 minus 3. So multiplying by 3 divided by 3, multiplying divided by 3 have. So this is the 3 into 5 into 7. Every series starting with 1, add and subtract the 1. 3 by 1 into 1 by 4 plus 3 into 5 by 2 factorial into 1 by 4 whole square minus 3 into 5 into 7 by 3 factorial into 1 by 4 whole cube plus up to infinity. Here added plus 1 minus 1 have. So this is the formula, up to this is the formula I have. 1 plus x whole power minus p by q. Obviously p is the 3, q is the difference. This is the common difference q. X by q value have 1 by 4, x equal to 2 by 4, that is 1 by 2. Next, p value have 3. So substitute in the formula, 1 minus x whole power minus p by q. One plus x whole power minus p by q. Alternate plus minus means between plus you have extra minus 1. So minus 1 by 3 into 1 plus 1 by 4. 1 plus x value is 1 by 2. Whole power minus p by q means p value is 3 minus 1. 1 plus 1 by 2 means 3 by 2. 3 by 2 whole power minus 3 by 2 means this power is a negative, so you can take the reciprocal. Minus 1 by 3 into 2 by 3 whole power 3 by 2 plus 1 here. 2 by 3 whole power 3 by 2 means 1 minus 1 by 3 into 2 by 3 a power 3 by 2 means a power 1 into a power 1 by 2, that is the root of 2 by 3, root 2 by root 3. 1 by 3 is outside here. Two root two by three root three minus one, that is a minus one by three into two root two minus three root three by three root three. Minus sign you can multiply to numerator. Minus into minus plus, three root three minus two root two by three, three is a 9 root 3. Yeah. This is the answer. Copy it. Coming to next question, the given expansion 1 plus x whole power n, given expansion x 1 plus x whole power n, tr plus 1 value is ncr x power r formula. The given second term and third term are a and b is given, that is a is second term t2, that is t1 plus 1, that is nc1 x power 1, that is nx. B is given third term, that is t2 plus 1, the value is nc2 x square, is n into n minus 1 by 2 into 1 x square. You can take b by a, you have to find the value of x, so x square by x means x will get, that is n into n minus 1 by 2 into 1 by n, x square by x will get, x is cancel, nn get cancel, that is n minus 1 by 2 x have. So 2b by a, you have n minus 1 into x. This can be done as nx minus x. But what is the value of nx? Nx is the value of a. So 2b by a equal to a minus x. Minus x change left hand side, that becomes a plus x equal to a minus 2b by a. Take the LCM, a is LCM. A into a square minus 2b. So finally x value is a square minus 2b by a have. Copy it. Observe the next question. 18 cube plus 7 cube, that means a cube plus b cube. Clearly it is in the form of 18 cube plus 7 cube plus 3 times of 18 into 7. 25 can be written as 18 plus 7 whole divided by, I will let 1, 6 means 61, 15 means 62, 20 is 63, 15 is 64, 60 is 61, 1 is 66. This is the 3 power 6, 3 power 5 into 2 power 1, 3 power 4 into 2 square, 3 cube into 2 cube, 3 square into 2 power 4, 3 power 1 into 2 power 5, 64 is 2 power 6 obviously. So this is the 3 power 6, 60 naught into 2 power 6, 3 power 6, 60 naught means 1, 61 means 6, 3 power 5 into 2 power 1, 15 can mean as 62 into 3 power 4 into 2 square, 20 can mean as 63 into 3 cube into 2 cube, 15 can mean as 64 into 3 square into 2 power 4, 6 can be written as 61 into 3 power 1 into 2 power 5 plus 66 into 2 power 6. Numerator is in the form of a cube plus b cube plus 3ab into a plus b. That is a plus b whole cube. 18 plus 7 whole cube by, this is in the form of nc0 x power n plus nc1 x power n minus 1 a power 1 plus nc2 x power n minus 2 and so on ncn a power n. That is 3 plus 2 whole power 6. So this value is 18 plus 7 is 25 whole cube by 5 power 6. 25 means 5 square. 5 square whole cube is 5 power 6 by 5 power 6. Both get cancelled. 1 will get answer. Copy it. Binomial theorem easy nana, whenever if you practice the problems, if you not practice the problems it is too difficult. Meer practice cheyapothe chaala difficult avutundandi. So practice chesthe chaala easy avutundi binomial theorem. Coming to this question, 10th one, it is in the form of x plus a, this is x plus a whole power n, a is x cube minus 1 whole power n by 2 plus x minus a whole power n, this is in the form of x plus a whole power n plus x minus a whole power n, a is x cube minus 1 whole power n by 2, x is x, is a polynomial of degree is they asking, that means you have to convert it into polynomial form and find the highest power of x you have to find. We know that x plus a whole power n plus x minus a whole power n expansion, that is 2 times of nc0 x power n plus nc2 x power n minus 2 ask plus nc4 x power n minus 4 a power 4 plus nc6 x power n minus 6 a power 6. Here n is the 5, so 566 does not exist. 5C6 does not exist. So up to you have to apply 5C4. Up to you have to apply 5C4. So you can expand by using the expansion. In place of A, you can take the x cube minus 1 whole power 1 by 2. X plus x cube minus 1 whole power 1 by 2 whole power 5 plus x minus x cube minus 1 whole power 1 by 2 whole power 5. Apply the formula 2 times of nc0 means 5c0 x power 5 plus 5c2 x power 5 minus 2 means 3, a is x cube minus 1, x cube minus 1 whole power 1 by 2 whole square plus 5c4 x power 5 minus 4 is 1, x cube minus 1 whole power 1 by 2 whole power 4, close the bracket. So this is the 2 times of 5c0 means 1 x power 5, 5c2 means 5 into 4 by 2 into 1 x cube whole square will cancel x cube minus 1, 5c4 value is 5 into x cancel, 2 times it cancel, a minus b whole square you can expand, x cube whole square is x power 6 plus 1 minus 2x cube. So finally we will get 2, so 2 times of x power 5, 10 x cube into x cube, 10 x power 6 plus into minus minus 10 x cube, 5x into x power 6, 5 x power 7, 5 into x power 6, 5 2s are 10, 5x into x cube, that is 10 x power 4, is a polynomial. It is does not contain any radical powers. So quotients are real numbers. So degree of the polynomial, degree highest power of x is 7. Highest power of x is 7. So degree is 7. Copy it. See the next question. If the ratio of 7th term from the beginning and the 7th term from the end, I will give one more point. Rth term from end. And in 1 x plus a whole power n is n minus r plus 2th term from the beginning. Is n minus r plus 2 term from the beginning. Rth term from the end equal to n minus r plus 2 term from the beginning. They given 7th term from the end, the ratio of 7th term from end and the 7th term from the, sorry, the ratio of 7th term from the beginning to 7th term from the end. 7th term from the end means n minus 7 plus 2 is 1 is to 6, that means 1 by 6. That is t 7 by t minus 7 plus 2 is n minus 5 equal to 1 by 6 is given. Cross multiplying 6 times of t 7 can be as 6 plus 1 equal to n minus 5 can be as n minus 6 plus 1. Apply the formula, given expansion is 2 power 1 by 3, cube root 2 means 2 power 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 power 1 by 3 whole power n. This is in the form of x plus a whole power n. Tr plus 1 formula, you know, ncr x power n minus r a power r. Substitute in this one, nc6, x means 2 power 1 by 3 whole power n minus 6, 1 by 3 power 1 by 3 whole power 6. Equal to right side you have nc n minus 6, 2 power difference of the both is 2 difference of the both n minus of n minus 6, that is 6 1 by 3 power 1 by 3 whole power n minus 6. So cross multiplication we get 6 tenths of nc6, 2 power n minus 6 by 3, 3 1s are 3 2s are cancel, 1 by 3 square equal to nc n minus 6 means nc6, 2 square 3 2s are cancel, 1 by 3 power n minus 6 by 3. Cross multiplication both nc6 nc6 get cancelled, that is denominator taking numerator, 2 times of 2 power 6 times of 2 power n minus 6 by 3, 3 power n minus 6 by 3 taking left hand side, 3 power n minus 6 by 3 equal to 2 square into 3 square, that is 6 square. So square to 6 get cancelled, 2 into 3 6 power n minus 6 by 3 equal to right side 6 power 1, base is equal, then equate the powers, n minus 6 by 3 equal to 1, n minus 6 equal to 3, then n equal to 3 plus 6, that is a 9. Copy it. x plus a whole power n. See this expansion. X plus a whole power n contain n plus 1 terms. That is t1 plus t2 plus t3 plus t4 plus and so on you have. T5 plus T6 and so on. Sum of the odd terms and sum of the even terms are P and Q. P is the sum of odd terms. That is T1 plus T3 plus T5 and so on. Q is the sum of even terms. As second term plus fourth term plus and so on. If we take P plus Q whole power, P plus Q. That is T1 plus T2, we get T1 plus T2 plus T3 plus T4 plus and so on. This is the X plus A whole power N. If you take the difference P minus Q, you have T1 minus alternately Q before minus N, so T minus T2 minus T4 and like that we get T1 minus T2 plus T3 minus T4 plus and so on. This is the value of X minus A whole power N. Alternately plus and minus means between minus we will get. Now they are asking p square minus q square. So that is a square minus b square can be as a plus b into a minus b. A plus b have x plus a whole power n. P minus q have x minus a whole power n. A power n into b power n is a into b whole power n. X plus a into x minus a whole power n. A plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square. X square minus a square whole power n. This problem already we did in IPE. IPE lo chesanu na meek emaina doubt undandi you can make a call to me. Naaku call cheyandi meek emaina doubts undayi 9703013007. Ee phone number meek telusa already. Naa call chese 24 hours eppudaina nenu availability lo untanu. Meek emaina doubts unde clear cheyagalutanu. Okay andi, don't miss the class. Daily update ayipoyada YouTube link pampistha undanu. Everyday class new problems undayi. Today up to 12 problems complete chesam xi2 lo. Tomorrow some more problems complete chedam. Okay na, all the best.